Hi, this is Kavita Sani and I am a legal intern of Lexington Company and I am a law student of IME Law College, and today we are going to discuss about a new topic, which is New Education Policy of 2020, NEP. An NEP is a comprehensive framework to guide the development of education in the country. The need for a policy was first felt in 1964 when Congress MP Siddheshwar Prasad criticized the government for lacking a vision and philosophy for education. In the same year, a 17-member education commission headed by the UGC chairperson D.S. Kothari was constituted to draft a national and coordinate policy on education. Based on the suggestion of this commission, Parliament passed the first education policy in 1968. A new NEP usually comes along every few decades. The first education policy came in 1968 under the Indira Gandhi government, and the second in 1986 under the Rajiv Gandhi government, and respectively. The NEP of 1986 was revised in 1992 when the P.V. Narasimha Rao was our Prime Minister. The third NEP released on 29 July 2020 under the Prime Ministership of Mr. Narendra Modi. In 2014, BJP included new education policy in their manifesto, and in 2015, Smriti Irani was a HRD minister and she formed a committee whose chairperson was Mr. T.S.R. Subramaniam, and this committee submitted their report on 7th May 2016, and the main objective of this committee was to improve the quality of the education and credibility of the education, addressing the gaps in implementation. In October 2016, Ministry released the draft, but this committee's suggestion failed. After this new committee was formed under the chairmanship of Dr. K. Kasturi Rangam with 9 other members, and they drafted the National Education Policy in 2019 and finally passed our New Education Policy of 2020. The three most important changes of NEP 2020 are: HRD Ministry, now renamed as Ministry of Education, and second, government investment in education increased from 1.6% to 6%, and the third, focusing on gross enrollment ratio, it will be increased to 50% by 2035. In school education, policy focuses on the overhauling curriculum, an easier board exam, and a reduction in the syllabus to retain core essentials, and thrust on explained learning and critical thinking. In a significant shift from 1986 policy, which pushed for 10 plus 2 structure, 10 plus 2 structure of school education, and the new NEP pitches for a 5 plus 3 and 3 plus 4 design corresponding to the age group of 3 to 8 year for foundational stage, and 8 to 11 preparatory stage, and 11 to 14 middle stage, and 14 to 18 secondary stage. This brings early childhood education, and the midday meal program will be extended to preschool children. The NEP says students until class 5 should be taught in their mother tongue or regional language, and also encouraged to learn coding from class 6. The policy also proposes phasing out of all institutions offering single streams, and that all universities and colleges must aim to become multidisciplinary by 2030. The NEP proposes sweeping changes, including opening up of Indian higher education to foreign university, dismantling of the UGC and the All India Council for Technical Education, and the introduction of a 4-year multidisciplinary undergraduate program with multi-exit options, and discontinuation of the MPhil program. To encourage multidisciplinary education, Meru set up. Now we discuss what changes done for teachers with consultation of NCERT National Curriculum Framework for Teacher Education NCFT 2021. By 2030, minimum teaching degree qualification is 4-year integrated BL degree. The main motive behind this policy to improve education standard and to remove the gap between private and government education. So that's all for today. I hope you guys like this video and learn something from it. And so do like, share, comment and subscribe the channel. Thank you.